All right, so I'm going to talk to you a little bit about what we do at Seed Savers Exchange to germinate carrots. So we're out here in our catalog garden. We've got four different varieties planted. This variety that we're going to look at here is a red cord Chantenay carrot. And to really simplify germinating carrots, we use drip irrigation because carrots take a couple of weeks to germinate. It takes consistent watering to keep the soil moist in order to get really good germination. And so what we do is we use this drip irrigation line, and right after we seed the carrots, we lay, and we've kind of moved it now, but we lay this drip line right over kind of the pressed in area where we had put the seeds. And that way we're only watering the area in which we want germination to happen, because if we're watering with a watering can or overhead irrigation, a lot of times we can get really significant weed pressure over that 2 weeks over the whole garden bed. And so by concentrating the water to where we want things to germinate, not only are we lightening the amount of weeding that we have to do, but we're really focusing our attention on that area where we want the carrots to come up. So you can see the germination quality that we have here is really good. You can see that we're getting a few weeds that are coming kind of right along where the carrots are at, but significantly less in these open areas. And so that really helps minimize the amount of additional work that it takes. And then once those carrots do come up, what we'll do is we'll just slightly slide the drip line to the side so the carrots can grow and we can kind of continue to water them. One of the things to keep in mind is with the drip line that that you get, the spacing for the emitters comes in 4, 6, 8, and 12 inches. Kind of as a standard, I like to use the 4-inch emitter spacing just because it gives a kind of a nice consistent moisture level along the whole line. And yeah, that's how we germinate carrots, and good luck.